Alright, what up everyone, it's Kirtan Singh, I'm back with a brand new video. So, I got back from work today, changed, went into my homeware, and then I was like, wait a second, I have to review the chapter 4 of The Mandalorian. So chapter 4 of The Mandalorian was a mixed bag, to say the least. It's a good episode. There was character development, there was lore, there was action, and it was everything I wanted and I got from the third episode, but it was done in a worse way. The episode once again falls short in its length and there not being enough substance in the time that we're given, where the third episode was short, but then what we got was enough to make it feel like something really happened and it didn't feel like that. But this episode was really short. The relationship between the Mandalorian and that the farmer lady was very poorly established, because she really got into him way too quickly. I don't know what was going on there. They skip ahead a few weeks as well, and they really could have used those few weeks to really develop that relationship between him and the farmers, but then they decide to have him go on the move again at the end of the episode. But the thing is that the way that they went about doing that was so poorly conceived, because the Mandalorian should already know that they're tracking Baby Yoda, the child, but he's willing to let Baby Yoda, the child, just stay in the farmer's village and just go on his own adventure. He should be smarter than that. But the overall episode has some pretty good action. I do love how the Imperial Walker looks and moves. The one thing that feels a little weird is that it feels a little too fluid in some of its movements, where it stops its leg just before it goes into the pond itself and then goes back to its two previous before the pond itself. It works, but it just seemed too fluid for a walker, which we've seen before already, acting too much in a staggering motion. Other than that, I enjoyed the Rebellion Shock Trooper. I can't remember her name at all, but I enjoyed her character. Baby Yoda was, as always, amazing. It teleports a lot, and, you know, I can explain that through, you know, moving with the Force like Yoda does. But the child, instead, we already know, gets weakened when it uses the Force. So I think it just teleports everywhere for convenience sake. How it just appears when the Mandalorian and the Rebellion Shock Trooper, ex-Shock Trooper, you know, fighting and whatnot. But, you know, I'm not going to complain because I enjoyed it nonetheless. So overall, this episode is a mixed bag. I'd say it's like the first episode in quality because I enjoyed it. But at the same time, there were a few problems with it. I personally might not have liked this episode as many other people would have, so let me know in the comment section down below what you thought of this episode. Did you like it? Didn't you? What are you hoping to see next? Because I'm hoping we finally get an answer as to how the bounty hunters, how the Imperials are tracking the child. Because that seems like the next place to go, so we can actually progress the story even more and get less of this filler-like episode. That all the way, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Until next time. I'll see you guys.